ASEAN needs a new vision to end the Myanmar killings. Yes, ASEAN needs a new vision. The peoples of ASEAN aspire to a peaceful, democratic region that respects human rights. ASEAN governments are failing to effectively address the unfolding Myanmar crisis. While the brave pro-democracy protesters of Myanmar are being killed by the military junta, all other ASEAN governments are demonstrating a lack of political will and unity to pressure the military junta to end the killings. The events in Myanmar display yet again the importance of ASEAN governments in dealing with regional crises. For decades, ASEAN governments have consistently failed to protect their peoples from one crisis to another, including transnational haze pollution, the Rohingya humanitarian disasters, and a multitude of anti-democratic and human rights abuses. At the heart of the matter, ASEAN governments have been handicapped by the self-imposed doctrine of non-interference. This doctrine may have been needed in the past, but it has since become a major hindrance and stumbling block to the development of participatory democracies and the protection of the basic rights of the peoples of ASEAN. We demand our respective ASEAN governments abandon the old doctrine of non-interference and pursue a new approach of constructive and critical engagement with the option of imposing trade and economic sanctions on the Myanmar military junta. All other ASEAN governments must unite and send an unequivocal message to the Myanmar military junta to immediately free all political prisoners, to restore the political situation in Myanmar to that prior to the 1st February 2021 coup, and to respect the people's votes in the November 2020 general elections. All those responsible for the killing of innocent people must also be prosecuted and brought to justice. Failing which, all ASEAN governments must unite and suspend Myanmar's membership from ASEAN, and thereafter impose targeted trade and economic sanctions against the military junta and their associates. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, our thoughts and our prayers go to Daw Aung San Suu Kyi and all her martyrized supporters in Myanmar. They will never be forgotten by supporters of democracy in Asia. As Cambodia's opposition leader, I last met with Daw Aung San Suu Kyi in Yangon in March 2013 on the occasion of a Congress of the National League for Democracy. A few days before, I had met with Anwar Ibrahim in Kuala Lumpur, and I conveyed his greetings to Daw Aung San Suu Kyi in Yangon. At that time, 8 years ago, the three of us started to develop the idea of active solidarity among ASEAN peoples who share the same ideals of freedom and democracy with respect for human rights.